Hi everyone, in this video we are going to be creating a nested ESXi host inside of our program virtual infrastructure. I've already got a remote desktop session open into the infrastructure virtual machine that we already created, and now I'm going to open a window into the vSphere client for the program infrastructure. Already have checked this out, so I've got a link set up for that. I will log in using my college ID. I'm going to select my folder and I'm going to create a new virtual machine. I have to give it a name, which is going to be based on the lab exercise document. I will make sure that my resource pool is selected for compute resource, my data store is selected for storage, compatibility is going to be the latest hardware version. For the guest operating system, I'll select other and then ESXi 6.5 and later. Notice that it says we're unsupported. Doesn't mean it doesn't work. All it means is if it breaks, we can't call for support. Okay, most of our hardware is configured. CPU, two CPUs is fine. Although I am going to scroll down here, we do have to expose the hardware-assisted virtualization flag from the CPU. And I'm also going to enable CPU performance counters, because that will be useful for later labs. Memory is fine. Hard disk, I'm going to thin provision. And right now we have one network adapter, which is connected to port group one. I need three more network adapters, four in total. Click on add a new device. And we'll select network adapter. So we've got another new network adapter. We're going to do that two more times. I'm going to scroll down here a little bit to look at our network adapters. So here's our first network adapter, which is port group one, which is fine. Second network adapter, which is also port group one, and that is fine. I'm going to scroll down to the third network adapter. This is going to change from port group one to port group two. And then I'm going to take the last network adapter and change this from port group 1 into port group 3. It's really important that you make sure that these network adapters are connected to the correct port groups. If you don't do that, you're going to have some troubleshooting to do in later labs. So just make sure you double check before finishing that up. One other thing that we need to do is we will take our optical disk. We're going to connect this to an ISO so that we can install ESXi. I'll select the ISO's data store. And if I scroll down, we'll see that we have this selection, which is ESXi 6.7. So I'll pick that, say OK, and also have to remember to expand this out and select connect it power on. We'll go next and finish. It will create our new virtual machine, which is right here. And now we're ready to power this on and go through the configuration. So I'll select power on. And then once it becomes available, we will launch the web console so that we can see what's going on. I'll have to tell Firefox to allow pop-ups from that particular web address. And we'll follow through with the installation. I'm going to be pausing at various points in the installation because otherwise we're just going to be spending minutes watching a progress bar, and that's not really very useful. So I'll come back when we get some prompts to actually do something. Okay, so we have our first prompt, which is pressing enter to continue the installation. I will do that. We have to accept the end user license agreement, which is F11. We'll do that. The installer is now scanning what hardware we have available to perform some configuration, and then we'll have a couple of questions to ask. Specifically, what disk are we going to install onto? There is only one. I'll press enter. We want US keyboard layout. We'll put in our password that we're using for the class. And it now wants to know if we're ready to actually perform the installation. Just so you know, if you're installing on something at this point, it's going to erase whatever is on the storage. So if you've got something previously on there that's not backed up, you might want to stop and make sure you do that. Let's press F11 and it's off to do the install. I'm going to again pause the video and we'll come back when it's ready to reboot. Okay, we're back with the reboot prompt. All I have to do is press enter. And that will reboot. And I'm going to pause because it's going to take a minute or so, and we'll see what happens once that's rebooted. Okay, that reboot is done. We have our console screen that's up, and we're basically ready to go. We're going to look at post-installation configuration in another video, meaning that this is a wrap for this video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.